Children, good morning. We have already dealt with the pollination and the fertilization process in the previous class. Once again, I'll recall the topic using this chart now. See the board and the chart over here, children. So this is about the pollination. So you know that pollination, during pollination, what happens? See here, children. A new seed begins when the male sex cell in the pollen grain joins with the female sex cell in an ovule. The first step in making this happen is called as pollination. Pollination takes place when the pollen grain from the anther moves to this, carried to the stigma. This transfer of pollen grains is carried out either by winds. See here this picture, the pollen grains transferred through the wind or water. This in picture, you can see the male flower and the female flower where the pollen grains are transferred from the anther to the stigma through water or by insects or birds or human beings also at times. So this is the pollination is carried by wind, water, insects, birds, etc. So you can see this picture where pollination takes place in two types. This is the self-pollination and this is the cross-pollination. See this picture, children, the self-pollination. This is the anther. Pollen grains are present in the anther. They are transferred to the stigma of the flower. When the pollen grains transfer through the, any of the agents of pollination, they reach the stigma. If it is in of the same flower, then it is called as self-pollination. If the transfer of pollen grains is from anther of one flower to the stigma of another flower, then it is called as cross-pollination. Pollen carried to the stigma in another flower is called as cross-pollination. Hope you have understood about the pollination, children. Now, I tell you about the fertilization. What is fertilization? Fertilization means fusion of male and female gametes. Fusion of male and female gametes. See here, children. This is the picture of fertilization. This is the pollen tube. The pollen, sorry, pollen grain. Germination of the pollen grain. This is the pollen tube. So you can see in this picture, this is the developing pollen grain. A, this is a developing pollen grain which contains the protoplasm, the inside the pollen grain, the structure of the pollen grain you can see, and a matured pollen grain. This is a mature pollen grain which contains the two nucleus, generative nucleus and the vegetative cell nucleus, which is within the tube cell. So after pollination, what happens? After pollination, the stigma nourishes the pollen grains. So when the pollen grains falls over the stigma, this is the stigma, structure of the female reproductive phase. See here, this is the gynoecium which consists of ovary, style and stigma. Ovary, style and stigma. When pollen grains falls over the stigma, there are some sticky substances present on the stigma which helps the pollen grain to germinate. So the germination of the pollen grain takes place over here. During the germination, what happens? A tube grows. A tube grows from the pollen grain. This is a pollen grain. A tube grows from the pollen grain with the male part. So this is the male part, means that is the male nucleus. Okay, the male part, when it moves through the style and reaches the ovary through the micropyle, that is the entry of the ovary. So this tube along with the male part, tube nucleus and generative nucleus, it ruptures through the germ pore and penetrates through the stigma and moves through the style carrying the tube nucleus followed by the generative nucleus. Tube nucleus and generative nucleus. You can see here, children. So the two nucleus, that is the developing pollen tube, this is the developing pollen tube along with the male nuclei, tube nuclei and the generative nuclei. This Generated nuclei divides to form two male gametes. This is the pollen grain produced when the pollen grain comes into contact with the chemical secreted by the stigma of the same species. Okay, the pollen tube grows down, making the way through the style to deliver the male gametes to the female gamete into the ovule. So this is the ovule present inside the ovary of the female. Okay, so to the female gamete, it releases the male gamete, it fuses with the male gamete fuses with the female gamete. This is the ovary wall. Ovule is attached to the ovary wall by a stalk. Okay, small stalk. So this is about the nucleus, the egg cell. This is the egg cell and the synergids. The male nuclei fuses with the egg cell and develops into the zygote. Is it clear? So the fusion of male and female gametes result in the formation of zygote. That is called as fertilization. After successful fertilization, the sepals, petals, anthers, stigma and the style. So what happens to them? So the wither away, they wither away. Fertilized ovule becomes the seed with zygote forming the embryo. So fertilized ovule, after the fertilization, it becomes the seed with zygote forming the embryo, and the ovary forms the fruit after the fertilization. So after fertilization, we can say that the seed develops from the ovule and ovary usually develops from the fruit. The entire process of fertilization forming the zygote is known as sexual reproduction. Okay, children? So the entire process of the formation of the zygote is called sexual reproduction. Hope you have understood this, children. Once again, I repeat, when the pollen grain falls over the stigma, there are some sticky substances over the stigma which helps the pollen grain to develop the pollen tube, and the tube along with the male gametes reach the female gamete, that is the female nuclei present inside the ovary in the ovule part, and fuses with it to result, which results in the formation of zygote. So after the formation, after the fertilization, what happens? The sepals, the petals, all the they what happens to them? They wither away, and the seed, it develops from the ovule, and the fruit develops from the ovary. This is how the formation of zygote takes place, which is known as the sexual reproduction. Hope you have understood, children, now. So children, what is fertilization? Fusion of male parts with the female parts to form a structure called zygote is called a fertilization. Okay, and here you see here, this is the sexual reproduction. The entire process of fertilization and formation of zygote is known as sexual reproduction. The entire process of